Hello guys and welcome to yet another Han 4.0 leaks. This is in fact the last episode as the patch will be released in about 6 days, so this is episode 5 out of 5. I do hope you enjoyed watching these sneak peeks before the actual patch. And in this particular episode we'll be looking through Alonia, Ogi, Taro, Clanks, as well as Barrier Idol and Sacrificial Stone. And last but not least, we have a remake of Sir Bensington. Sir Bensington is a hero that has not been played a lot recently, so it will be very interesting to see how you guys will actually play with the new abilities. So looking forward to that. Hope you'll enjoy the episode. I'll see you at the end of the video. Alonia is our first hero out. The mana cost in Q has been reduced by 20 per level, as well as the cast action time reduced with 100 milliseconds per level. The same goes for the W ability. This is quite a significant buff, and I do believe Alonia will be picked after this. As for the ultimate, it's now superior magic damage. This includes the damage and the application of the movement speed slow, which basically means you can use it through Shrunken Head. The Staff of the Master effect, however, is not applicable through Shrunken Head, and you cannot freeze every single hero. As for Ogi, the Q ability is no longer adjusted based on proximity to the center of the explosion. The magic damage has been increased by 20 per level, and the movement speed slow bonus based on proximity to the center of the explosion has been decreased by 30% to 20%. The W ability's max mana drain from self was decreased from 5% to 4% per second, allowing you to use it more. And for the E ability, we have a tiny nerf at the beginning of the ability, but a buff in the later stages of the ability, from 4-6-8-10% to 3-6-9-12%. Next up is Taro. Ricochet now prioritizes targets affected by your Bound by Fate. That means if you use a Q ability on the two targets Bound by Fate, it will prioritize them and damage them instead. Bound by Fate also got a significant buff where the movement speed slow was increased from 10 to 15%. It can now be casted on magic immune targets, and if a unit dies while tethered to another, the other unit is pulled towards them and has the regular damage and stun applied to them, making this a very good ability. Next up is Clanks. Agility gain per level was increased by 0.2, the attack projectile speed decreased from 9,000 to 400 units per second. Action type on Hawk was changed from target self to passive, terrain walking on the skill remains active while Hawk is active, and can now be toggled on or off with a 3 second cooldown. It starts with 4 charges, and every time Clanks receives a non-dot damage instance from an enemy hero, 1 charge is lost on Hawk. When Hawk reaches 0 charges, the benefits of the skill are lost and the skill goes on a 10 second cooldown. Charges refresh once every 10 seconds, but the refresh timer is restarted when Clanks receives damage. If Hawk is on cooldown, the timer will not be present. Movement speed bonus changed from 10% to 5, 10, 15, 20%, and it is no longer purgeable with Mulfire Blade, for example. As for the fourth ability, aka the ultimate, the mana cost has been changed from 100, 125 to 150 to 50, 100, 150. Duration increased by 5 seconds per level, and all drones have been changed once again. The first one fires a bolt of lightning that bounces to a total of 3 units, dealing 30 magic damage, and deals double damage to non-hero units. Second drone deals 20% of your base damage and magic damage, and the third drone heals Clanks for 30% of his basic damage. Visual changes, all drones fly within 350 radius from Clanks at all times while active. It has also been renamed to attack drones. I'm sorry, automated target kill drones. Next up we got Sir Bensington. The Q ability has the stun increased by 1 second per level, the touch radius was increased by 20 allowing you to hit it easier, and the range was increased by 200. The cast action time was also reduced from 600 to 400. The E ability also passively causes Bensington to increase his attack range by 50, 100, 150, 200 and pierce through 1, 2, 3, 4 magic armor when dealing damage from his auto attacks or spells. Royal Stomp has been removed, and in its place the E has been moved from the first slot to the second slot. It no longer grants bonus range passively, but the number of max charges reduced from 4 to 3. On use, your attack cooldown is reset. It no longer sets your attack range to a flat number, it now grants plus 100 range for the next attack. Damage per charge increased from 15, 25, 35, 45 to 15, 30, 45, 60. The base damage decreased from 40, 80, 120, 160 to 30, 60, 90, 120. The mana cost has been decreased as well from 85, 100, 115, 130 to 80, 90, 100, 110. This will help the hero drastically. can now be switched into auto cast by right clicking to automatically cast the ability when attacking a valid target at free charges. Ultimate no longer targets an enemy, now targets the ground and has been increased to global. Upon use now starts a 2-second channel at the end of which Benson launches into the air and lands at the target location after a 1-second delay. If interrupting the channel, cancels the effect but still consumes the cooldown and the mana cost. A shadow effect appears at target location at the start of the channel, warning enemies that Benson is coming. 3 seconds total before impact. It plays a globally audible drum roll sound at the start of the channel. The cooldown has been changed from 180-60 to 120-110-100. It still applies the same damage and slow as before. Barrier Idol. Bonus agility increased from 2 to 5. Shield changed from blocking pre-mitigation damage to blocking post-mitigation damage. This means that magic armor will now positively impact the amount of magic damage blocked by the barrier. Magic damage blocked by the barrier reduced from 400 to 300. Non-hero units affected receive a barrier that blocks 600 magic damage instead of 300 magic damage, heavily helping your pushing ability with this item. Sacrificial Stone. When charged, armor buff now also gives allies plus 3 to all stats, but not to yourself. Buff duration was increased from 30 to 45, and mana cost decreased from 25 to 10. Cooldown was also increased from 25 to 30. It no longer reduces the amount of gold you lose on death, and it no longer leaves behind a shard that collects experience or grinds clear vision. Death timer reduction increased from 12 to 20 seconds. Thank you guys very much for watching episode 5 out of 5 of Han 4.0 Leaks. This was the final episode, as I mentioned previously in this video. So if you do enjoy the video, don't forget to leave a like down below, share the video, as well as subscribe to my channel. You can also check out the previous episode right here. It will pop up on top of my hand. And another random video on my channel up here. Thank you guys very much once again. And I will see you in another one of my videos. Peace out.